In today's Dr. Seuss Tips video, we're talking about how to avoid the Monday blues. You know, we've all been guilty of this at one point in our life, and hey, you may even still be dreading Monday. But in today's video, I'm gonna be helping you guys out, and we're gonna be talking tips to help you beat the Monday blues and hopefully learn to view it in a different perspective so you can hopefully be a little bit more optimistic about your Monday. So it's Sunday night. Perhaps you just had the most amazing weekend ever, or maybe you just had an okay weekend. But you find yourself dreading the next day instead of enjoying what's left of your weekend. Maybe you have homework to do, maybe you have a big presentation at work tomorrow, or maybe you're just dreading avoiding seeing someone that you just got into a fight with. Or hey, maybe you just hate your job. Normal thoughts could be crossing through your mind during this whole entire process on Sunday night of like, I'm going to fail my big test tomorrow, I'm not gonna do good on my presentation, or I'm going nowhere in my job. Well, this leads me to tip number one, and that is we have to be aware and catch these unhelpful thoughts that are affecting the way we view Monday. Remember, unhelpful thoughts, they influence our mood, it influences our productivity, our energy level, our actions. So it's so important to be aware of what's going through our head so we can actually do something about it. Moving forward, I just want you guys to know that with any tips that you learn in these videos, there's gonna be tips that are gonna help you prevent a problem, and then there's gonna be tips that help you intervene in the moment. It's obviously a lot harder to do something in the moment, and that's what catching unhelpful thoughts and changing them is a really, really hard skill to learn. So this is not a super easy skill to learn and requires years and years of practice. This is why I always talk about we have to practice these skills. If not, nothing's gonna change. So, but going back to this, we have to catch the unhelpful thoughts in order to change the way we view Monday in general. So here's an example. So it's Sunday and you notice that you're starting to feel a bit anxious. That's great that you've even realized that you're feeling this way. Ask yourself though, what was I just thinking? This is an example of a thought. I am going to totally mess up my presentation tomorrow and do a horrible job. Okay. That moment, great, you've identified the unhelpful thought. It is not going to help you do a better job at the end of the day tomorrow and in the rest of your Sunday evening. So what should you do instead? Try to pretend a friend is giving you advice. This is a really good way to change or like put a spin on the thought because your friend is going to tell you something positive. They're not going to tell you you are going to totally mess up on your presentation, because if that were the case, then you probably have a really bad friend. But that's a whole nother story. So in this situation, what do you think your friend would tell you after you told them how you felt? Well, they'd probably say, it's okay to be nervous. You know, who likes giving presentations? Well, actually, maybe some people do. But they'd probably say, you've been preparing for this presentation for the last month. You got this and you will do a great job. So that is a good way to practice changing the way that you've been thinking by removing it away from you, because you're in essence, pretending you have another friend giving you advice. So try doing this next time that you notice yourself feeling a strong emotion. So on to tip number two. So this is going to help prevent. Remember how I told you that there's gonna be skills to intervene or prevent? So this is a prevention skill. Try to make Mondays less boring, okay? So don't go and set everything up for your hard or your most boring tasks on Monday morning. Try instead doing them on Friday so that on Monday, it's a little bit easier for you. Tip number three, let's make Mondays more exciting. Hey, why is it that we have all the fun stuff on Friday? Well, yes, we have 2 days off the next day, but same concept. Why don't we start planning some fun activities on Monday, whether that is ordering your favorite food on Monday during lunch at work, or having a fun dinner at night, or going out to the movies, or going out somewhere. Since you are just creating more fun on Mondays, so you don't dread them as much. And tip number four is the last one, and this is, we have got to get a good night's sleep on Sunday night. I'm telling you, do not go past your bedtime. Try to follow the same bedtime routine every single night, including Sunday, because sleep greatly, greatly impacts and influences our mood and our energy level. So if you're already dreading your Monday and you don't get a good night's rest, you're only setting yourself up for a miserable day. Well, that's it. So I hope these tips help you have a better Monday. And as always, thank you so much for watching and following along. Don't forget to hit subscribe right over here so you can stay up to date with all of the latest Dr. C videos. And you can check out older Dr. C videos right over here. Don't forget to leave that thumbs up and leave a comment below on any of the tips. If you've been using them, if you like them, if there's something you don't like, or any ideas with what you'd like to see next. I'll see you soon.